everybody, welcome back to Rain and Pause. I'm Mitch, and today you're watching The Big Little Piggy Party. I'm so proud to be a part of this 10 artist collaboration to celebrate this little piggy pigment's turning one. So join me as I do a beach pour along with all of these other artists and celebrate these amazing pigments. Okay, so I have my huge hexagonal canvas here ready to go, and I've got some pillow paints here that I've had tinted at Bunnings. I've got some blue. Now this is a combination of blue paints that I had used previously, and I've put them into a single jar to make this really nice light blue color. But the original color was called glazed blue, and this is going to be the color that I'm using for my ocean and sky portion. I'm just going to pour that onto the top. And I hope I've got enough pillow. Now for swipes like I'm doing today, I generally don't put as much pillow as I do for a bloom, because I find that if you do, you'll end up with your cells getting overstretched and it doesn't look as nice. Then for my sand, I have this lovely peach color, and this is Plastic Fantastic. Again, a British Paints low sheen color. And that's going to be for my sand. It's more of a peach. Oh, it is actually a bit of a sandy color. That's going to go down here. Okay. And I'm going to use up another little bit of pillow paint that I've got laying about. And this is just a mixture of colors that I've been using up. This is like a tealy turquoise color. So I'm going to use this somewhere near the middle where my ocean and my sand join. Now I've got my teal turquoise pillow paint. It's really nice pale paint. And again, this is just a mixture of paints that I've had from previous pours. And that's going in the middle. So this won't be seen. This is more of a pillow, but it just gives some color underneath if any of it does show through. Okay, and I'm going to get rid of this little splodge here. I'll just mix that in. And with this, I'm going to spin this out to distribute a little bit more evenly. Okay, now to add all my colors. So the colors I'm going to put on first are, this one is Golden Permanent Violet Dark. And this does look a lot lighter than what is in the tube. I can't seem to get the same tube color to replicate when I mix it with my pouring medium. It's such a deep and pigmented color. Then I'm going to use this little piggy constellation. This is an amazing purple color. It's like a bluish purple. I'm going to go over the top of that purple color there. Then I've got this little piggy watermelon. An amazing watermelon pink color. So this is going to be the sunset portion. So for the ocean portion, I have Matisse Southern Ocean Blue mixed with Josonia Stormy Blue. Then I have Matisse Cobalt Teal mixed with white to really dull down the color, make it really pastel, nice blue here. Then I have this little piggy sea glass. this gorgeous aqua green color. It's lovely. Then my favorite piggy and my code word, which is this little piggy, macaw. So make sure you enter macaw on the TLP Facebook page when the competition is open. That is my code word. And you want to be looking out for the code words on each artist's channel. All you have to do is enter all 10 code words and you'll go into the running to win an awesome This Little Piggy prize pack, which consists of all 10 code word colors, as well as a $100 gift card to Fluid Art Co. to spend on whatever you like in their store. Now, macaw is an amazing indigo to gold interference color. That's why I love it so much. And I'm going to absolutely cover this with macaw because I really want to see that color shift come out. Then for my sand, I have some golden quinacridone nickel azo gold. I've got that same quin nickel azo gold mixed with white to give me a really nice lighter color. And then I have this little piggy ore, which is their light gold going on top. This is also another one of my personal favorite colors. I prefer this over the harvest gold because I find the harvest gold is really rich and really yellow. It does have its uses and it does have its place in pours, but I love the ore because of how light, and it's also quite rich. Just adds a really nice effect over the top of everything. Okay, now that that's on, we're going to add our cell activators. Now our cell activators, I'm going to swipe on the back of my tool and I'm going to do two lots. I'm going to be using black and white, white on the bottom, black on top. So that's the order I'm putting them on my spatula so that when I flip them over, the white is going to be the last layer on my pour. Loading up that spatula there. And the black on top of that. Okay, and here we go. Just to get some really nice cells in there. So I'm gonna go over this area again. Stop there. And I'm just making sure that my entire tool is covered with the cell activator. So I'm just tilting it side to side, making sure everything is covered. And I'm actually going to bring this down. There is a lot of paint on this canvas. And I'm going to do one more lot. Okay, last little bit, and let's carry this down over here. And I'm going to go over that little section again so I get some definition in my sand. Now we're going to spin this out and see what we get. Now I do want to tilt this up slightly, so I'm going to bring that towards me because it's easier to see. Tilt this paint. Now my pillow paints have different consistencies, which I should have rectified first, but I didn't. I'm also going to blow out these little bits of cell activator that I have. Okay, maybe that one too. So let's just give this a spin. All right, we ready? Making sure it's gonna spin freely. Here we go. Let's have a look, see what's happening. I don't want to lose all of my sky. So I want to tilt this and bring it down. So you can see the center of the paint moving here. Just walking everything down so I don't warp everything too much. I might have to walk that off the ends. Got an awful lot of blue. But that's okay. So let's keep spinning. Okay, and I think one more spin should do it. That's looking much better. All right. I'm super happy with how this turned out. Got some lovely sand down here, the ocean in the middle, and the sunset blending in. Amazing. Looks like turbulent waves. Okay, let's go down for a close-up, shall we? Thank you so much for watching, guys. That's my contribution to the TLP YouTube collaboration, My Beach Style Swipe. Now, please stick around for Raina. She's up next and she has an amazing painting coming up. I don't know how she's done it. So stay tuned for her and make sure you hang around for Shelley's video at the end. She'll give you all of the instructions to enter the TLP giveaway where you can win all 10 code word color This Little Piggy pigments, as well as a $100 Fluid Art Code gift card. So please stick around. Also check out the brand new This Little Piggy YouTube channel, which will be launching with the last video premiere, and have a look on the Fluid Art Co. website for the Little Piggy pigments. Now, I hope you've enjoyed what I'm doing, and if you're liking what I'm doing, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.